What's up everyone, Matt again with the Maya Learning Channel. In a previous video, I showed you the basics around exporting and then referencing in USD files in Maya to build up a USD scene. That was great for static objects, but what about things like characters and animation? Well, I'm happy to report that as of version 0.19, the Maya USD plugin can handle that easily too. So in this video, I'll show you how to reference Maya animation into a USD prim, then generate a USD cache from that, and then jump back and forth between the two data representations to perform some tweaks and fixes to the animation. So let's get started. So here we've got the same living room scene that I ended off with in my previous USD video, with some Arnold lighting thrown in. Since then, I used it to block out a short little animation you can see here. Currently, the animation just lives as normal Maya data outside the USD data, but now I want to move it in. To do that, first I'll need to export the animated character to its own Maya file, which is easy enough to do using Maya's export selected command. And then I can just delete the original from the scene. Next, just like any of the other props here, I want to add a new transform prim to the stage for MayaBot. But before we do that, I'm going to quickly go to the USD layer editor. Notice how my USD layers are organized by department. This is a concept I covered in my intro to USD video. Click the link above if you missed that one. Since the work I'm doing right now is animation related, I'm going to add a new layer under the anim layer, save it as MayaBot, and then activate it. Then I'll right-click to add my transform prim, rename it MayaBot, then right-click again and this time add a Maya reference to it. Then just navigate to my exported file. This brings my animation back as a reference under my MayaBot prim. And this is just one way to do this. I could have just as easily referenced in a static MayaBot file and then animated it as a reference instead. Either way though, notice that the expander is not a diamond like the others. Remember what I said in the previous video, the outliner uses these diamond expanders to indicate USD data. This is further backed up by the reference that has appeared in the lower outliner and in the reference editor. All of these indicate that the reference isn't quite USD data yet, even though it's being visually represented in the USD hierarchy here. So how do we convert it? Well, if I right-click it, you'll see I have the option to cache to USD, so I'll just do that. And give it a name. Then let Maya run through the animation to cache it out. And now you can see the reference has been replaced by a composition arc with a proper diamond expander I wanted to see before. Not only that, but the Maya reference has been unloaded, as evidenced by the fact that it's now grayed out. So now my animation is saved as USD data. Now the question remains, what if I need to make changes to my USD cache? For example, if I dolly in here, you can see some artifacts from the mocap data I used, like how the foot slides along the ground instead of lifting up here. Well, to do that, first note the V on the MayaBot prim, indicating that it now contains variants. If I right-click it, you'll see that I can return to the reference representation of MayaBot at any time by selecting it from here. And once the reference is back, I can edit it the same way that I'd edit any other USD data in Maya, by choosing to edit as Maya data. Next, I'm going to add a new anim layer with the light control I need to adjust. Then it's just a matter of making my changes. And once I'm happy with them, I can cache them out just like before. And there you have it, my tweaked animation as a USD cache. And of course, I can go back and forth as often as I like. So hopefully this gives you a good idea about how to bring animation into your USD workflow. As always, if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. And I'll see you in my next video on the Maya Learning Channel.